The Chargers took on the Bengals over the weekend, trying to capture their 7th victory in their last 8 games, but just fell short on what was a cold, windy day in Cincinnati. It was a tough first half for the Chargers with a few mistakes early in the first quarter, followed by a couple wind-affected punts. The Bengals were put in great field position to help give them the early lead and close out the first half up 13-3. To start the second half, the Chargers came out strong as Phillip Rivers put together an 8-play, 86-yard drive, ending in a Ryan Matthews 23-yard touchdown run to put the Chargers within 3 points of tying the game. But going into the fourth quarter, Carson Palmer continued to produce on offense, eventually giving the Bengals a lead that the Chargers didn't have enough time to catch.
We gave them extremely good field position early, and then when we got the game back to 13-10, gave them great field position with the interception and return.
As a quarterback, you feel like you have more of a hand in a win and a loss than anybody else. You touch the ball every play, and so certainly any game we lose, there's plays I wish I had back and things I wish I could have done to help us win. And in a season when you don't make the postseason, certainly feel the same way about that.
You know, I look at our team, and obviously it is disappointing that we haven't won more football games. But I look at individuals, and I look at the guys that have probably had the best year of their career. And I can go across the board, and Kaysan and Weddle and Jammer, Kevin Burnett is playing as high a level as he can play. Garay on defense. Look at the offensive guys. There's guys inside offensive line. Nick and Dillman played as well as Jacob Hester's played as well as he can play. Getting Randy McMichael and having the contribution he's had. We all know what Phillip's done. And these guys all have a chance to finish off a season on Sunday and be able to say, hey, I there was a couple ups and downs I'd like to change, which every player is going to have. But from a standpoint of what I accomplished this year as a player, I've had the best year of my career. And that's the way I know those guys are going to approach the game Sunday. And that's the way they're going to prepare. And that's the way they're going to go play.
The Chargers travel to Denver next weekend, looking to finish 9-7 on the season and end on a high note. I'm Nicoletta Rule with Chargers.com, and this is your weekly report.